Obler's plays. On the winds of the night, we bring you a story whispered in the night. This is a story of revenge. The scene is the end of a mountain trail. It is night, and at the edge of a cliff that lifts 500 feet above a river far below stand a man and a girl. The man is flashily dressed, his face smug and self-certain. As his arms go around the girl, she suddenly thrusts him away and steps back, her face tense and white.
Put up your hands, Mac Webber. Yes, this gun's a real one. Put up your hands, I said. Oh, I've waited 5 miserable years for this. No. This isn't a hold-up, Mac Webber. I don't want your money. I'll tell you what I want. I want to see you step off the edge of this cliff. Yes, that's what I said. I want to see you walk off into nothing. I want to hear you scream as you fall. I want to see your arms and your legs twisting and reaching for something that isn't there. That's what I want, Mac Webber. So you think I'm joking? Yeah. Yeah, it's a joke. It's a joke that's filled my days and my nights ever since that night he reached for something that wasn't there. He was different than you are, Mac Webber. In a minute, you'll be begging for life. But he didn't beg. He went out bravely because that's the only way he knew how to be. Step back off the cliff, Mac Webber. Step back. You can't understand why I want to kill you. Think back, Mac Webber. Think back to that night 5 years ago. That night you took him up here and gave him his choice either to help you or get thrown off that edge behind you. Think back.
Scared, kid? I know, Mr. Webber. Why should I be afraid?
Oh, I don't know. Some people can't stand being up in high places.
I don't mind.
You know, it's 500 feet down that river.
Back home, we kids used to go swimming in the quarry. Dive 30 or 40 feet. That was fun.
What's the matter, kid? You're having plenty of fun.
Mr. Webber, I want to talk to you.
No, ain't that funny? I've been wanting to talk to you, too, Joe. Yeah. That's why I brought you up here to the cliff tonight. I like to talk up here. I come up here lots of times at night. Sit here. Look down at the city. Ah, but I'm talking and you want to talk. Well, what's on your mind?
Mr. Webber, what kind of a business are you in?
What kind of talk is that?
I've got to know.
You giving orders now, Joe?
I don't want you to get sore, Mr. Webber, but I've got to know. Believe me, I've got to.
I don't like people that ask too many questions.
It's a legitimate business, isn't it, Mr. Webber?
Maybe I should get sore. Maybe I won't. Hey, you're just a big dumb punk from the farm, that's all. So let's forget it and go back to town. Come on.
Wait, Mr. Webber.
Maybe you ought to get sore.
Please, I'd like to know right away. It's all right. The business, isn't it?
Making dough, ain't you?
But things happen. I don't understand them.
You understand the dough, don't you?
Yes, but...
Well, so it's all right. Make it every week. Put it in your pocket and shut your mouth. Don't be trying to think so much. You'll hurt your head. Now, are you riding back with me or are you walking back?
Why don't you answer me, Mr. Webber?
3 weeks working for me. And I didn't know you had such a big mouth.
But I only want to know what...
You want to know too much.
Well, maybe I... Maybe I better find myself another job.
All right, kid. Maybe I better tell you all about it. What do you want to know? What's bothering you?
It's the money.
Huh?
Well, I thought I was delivering that money to a private bank all this time. Yesterday I heard the fellas talking and... They said those other people sell the money I bring to them.
Yeah, sell it. It doesn't make sense.
Don't it?
No, because why should they be selling money? What would be the point of selling a dollar for less than a dollar unless the money wasn't any good, unless the money wasn't any...
Maybe you're answering yourself, Joe.
It's true.
Come on, I'll buy you a drink.
Take your hands off
me. Listen. I don't like punks that raise their voices to me.
I don't care what you like. I'm through. I'm quitting.
What did you say, kid?
Gun. What did...
Didn't you have any guns like this back on the farm, Joe?
Pointing a gun at me, but why?
I'll give you the idea real quick, farmer boy. You came to me looking for a job. I didn't come looking for you. All right. So I gave you a job. So you keep it. Understand?
Counterfeit money. I don't want a job like that.
I told you. You got the job. You keep it.
But I
want to tell you something, punk. It's 500 feet straight down from here. And once in a while, a guy gets tired of living, and he jumps off. So the cops pick up what's left, and that's all. And once in a while, some guy that ain't tired of living, he jumps off. And all the ways down, he wants to keep on living. But when he hits the bottom down there, he's just as dead as the rest of them. You get what I mean, kid?
You can't make me do what I don't want to do. Fake money, that's criminal. Let's...
Shut up. So, I can't make you do what you don't want to do, huh? Listen, farmer boy. I'm going to tell you something else. All over the world today, there are punks like you doing things they don't want to do. And the guys like me that are making them do it are the guys that are sitting right up on top.
Now, look, Mr. Webber.
It's like I tell you. You do what you're told, the way I tell you to do it. Because if you don't, on a night like this, you're going to be flying out over the edge. And when you hit the bottom, there may be a couple of questions asked, but you won't be asking them. Now get going, punk.
So now you remember, Mac Webber. Joe Warner. That's right. No, I wasn't his girl. I was his wife. Wife. Joe. Can't sleep?
No.
Why?
I just can't. Blasted town, doesn't it ever stop?
I'll get up and shut the window.
No, don't. Gotta get some air in the place.
What's the matter, dear?
Nothing.
All these hours I've been lying here knowing you were awake. Tell me what's the matter, Joe.
Let's get out of here.
What?
This town, let's get out. Back to the farm.
But Joe...
What good is it here for either of us?
Joe, you're not serious.
I am. I'm asking you, what good is it for you or me?
Joe, you're talking crazy.
You asked me and I'm telling you.
You mean these weeks? You haven't been happy?
With you, yes. Just that... I want to go back to the farm.
I don't know what to say. We talked that out, I thought, so long ago.
Julie, I'm not made for the city. I'm not fitted, I tell you. My hands, they're for hard work. My head, I haven't got the right kind of brain. Need a brain like a rat to get along in this town.
So what's come over you? You've been doing so well. You got such a fine job. Making so much money. Why, my father never made in a month what you make in a week. I've been so proud of you.
Julia.
Oh, don't spoil everything now. All my life I've had nothing. For the first time I'm beginning to live the way I've wanted to. Don't spoil that, Joe. Just because the night is so hot and it's hard to sleep. And you're tired and want to talk crazy. Let me stay here where I'm alive and happy.
All right. All right.
He wanted me to be happy. So he didn't say anything more about anything that was troubling him, about you. And he went on doing what you wanted him to. Until that night. Remember that night, Mac Webber?
Okay, Joe. We wait here.
But I don't understand.
You talk so much. Stay back here. Max said he'd pick us up with Dan, and he will. There he is. Come on. Come on, I tell you. Walk slow.
I don't know what this is all
about. If Max want to tell you, he'll tell you. Hey, Max. Come on, get in. Get in. Sure, boy. Come on.
Mr. Weber, what
are we... Where is he, Lizelli? That thin fellow by the lamppost. Making off, he's reading the paper.
Sure?
Yeah. Joe dropped the bundle off at Mike's like you tell him. And this fella started tailing. He's been with us ever since.
Okay.
Mr. Weber, why don't you tell me what's going on?
I told you to shut your mouth. Here. Close your hand on this gun.
What?
Do what I tell you. Close your hand on the gun.
Okay.
Now, give it back to me. Hey, mister.
Talking to me?
Yeah. I got something for you, copper.
Shot him. You shot him.
Call him out. Okay.
No, don't. Let me go. Let me be. No.
The gun. Throw the gun at Mikey. Okay. Let's go.
But the gun was your gun, and the finger that pressed the trigger was your finger. But he died for that. With a rope around his neck, his legs twisting and reaching for ground that wasn't there, the way yours are going to twist and reach. Step back, Mac Weber. No, no, I don't want to listen to you. Joe wanted to live, too, the night the state took him away to die. We'd been together such a little time. 5 months. And now he's been dead. 5 years. But I remember every day of those 5 months. Every day. From the very first one. He's unhappy.
What do you think?
Oh, I think the sun is warm, the grass is soft, and the bride never had a bluer sky.
Bride?
Darling.
I love you, Julie.
Mrs. Warner.
Mrs. Warner. What?
I was just thinking of Reverend Wilson. His collar was so tight.
Oh, I want to hold you.
Joe, everybody's watching.
Everybody?
There's a whole row of crows on the fence wire over there.
Oh, let them watch. You're my wife now, Julie. My wife. My wife.
A wife. But not for long, Mac Weber. You thought of that. 5 months a wife. And now I'm thinking of the last 5 minutes we were together before they took him away to die. He put his arms around me. And our cheeks were close together. And his tears were my tears. He didn't cry because he was afraid like you are. He cried because of me. Because I was going to be all alone. I'm remembering those 5 minutes, Mac Weber.
I'm sorry, Joe. 5 more minutes.
All right, Warden.
Oh, Joe!
Julie!
No.
No, no. Please, darling. You've got to listen to me. Let me say.
Joe isn't right. It isn't. It isn't.
That's what I want to talk to you about, Julie. All these days, I've had a chance to think. Something I haven't done much of before.
This business of right and wrong. I used to tear my hands open on the wall yelling about justice, justice.
Oh, Joe.
No, no. Listen to me without tears, Julie. I want you to understand the way I've figured things out. I've figured out that in life, things just happen. There's no guarantee that truth will triumph and justice reigns supreme and all that stuff. That's just, well, it's a pipe dream that people have had for so many years, they've got to believe it's the truth.
Keep holding me.
But I tell you, Julie, in life there's no promise that things that are right will come out right. That's something for the books and the moving pictures. But it isn't real any more than it's real that I'll stop loving you 5 minutes from now.
Yeah.
Justice isn't something that's guaranteed in life, I tell you. I could only be sure that there'd be justice after I die.
Oh, I tell
can't stand it.
No, no. No, don't, please, don't. I'm not crying anymore. Why should I cry? Because I'll be dead. Sooner or later, everybody will be dead. The warden out there, the guards that walk me along, the poor guy that'll pull the switch, a handful of years and they'll all be dead. Yes. Even Mac Webber.
So I won't let them take me out of here. I won't let them.
Julie, baby, you were always the strong one. You were so much smarter than me. You are, you know. Be smart now and understand it my way. I've been lucky. 5 months with you. There were such wonderful days. I don't think life's cheated me any. Were there guys here in death row that haven't had more than a few hours when they were really happy? Really happy, like you and I were. This place, the city, the whole world's filled with plain, ordinary people who've never really been happy. Never. Cry for them, Julie. Not for me. I've had you.
Time, boy. You'll have to go with me, Mrs. Warner.
So it was time, Mac Webber. And Joe tried to smile, and he kissed my hand. And then they dragged me away. And a few minutes later, they took him out and hung him. And when he died, I wanted to die, too. But I couldn't die, because you were still alive. Step back, Mac Webber.
No, what's the use of you talking to me? I can't listen. I can't hear you. All that's in my head is that Joe's dead and you're alive and standing at the edge of the cliff. And in a minute, what I said I'd do that night he died, I'm going to do.
That night, the gates of the jail behind me, I stood there. So dark. Raining. I stood there and I looked up and down the street and all that I could think of was that you were alive. And I had to find you. I didn't know where you were. I'd never seen you. Only one picture of that face of yours. But I had to find you. I had to. Train after train. Town after town. Looking for you. Looking for you. I had to find you. I had to. Mac Webber. Mac Webber. Where was Mac Webber? Until at last my money was gone. I found myself back in this town where I'd started from. But you hadn't come back. And so I waited. Waited. 5 years. And then... tonight. I'd gone to Molly so many times because they told me it was your money that paid for her place. And so I went again and again, hoping, hoping, until tonight.
Well, if it ain't the little lady.
Hello, Molly.
Oh, so you still remember my name. Where you been? I figured you'd gone high hat or married or something.
Oh, I've been away.
Oh, away, huh? Yeah, well, I bet you found out there ain't no place like the old town. I says old places like old friends like old shoes. Nothing like them. speaking of shoes, mind if I sit down? Got a new pair of pumps and they're killing me. I got small feet, but that dirty little drift over on 2nd Avenue. What do you don't know about fitting shoes on a lady? Say, here I'm blowing off. I bet you're dying for a drink.
No, I just came into
Oh, that's okay, little lady. It's on the house. Hey, Sam, couple of big ones.
Coming up, Molly.
And I don't mean on the slow plate. Say, what was your name again?
Julie.
Oh, yes. Boy, have I got a kid. Well, when you stopped coming in here, I says to myself, Molly, the little lady's got herself a friend, I says. And you won't. Say, what are you staring at?
That man. At the bar.
Man? Oh, no. Oh, no, that's not your friend. That's mine.
Who is he?
You know, the only one that's found out there's nothing like the old place. Hey, big fella. Mac. Come on over. Friend of mine I want you to meet. He used to have this town right in his pocket, Mac did. But he had to go away. A light guy.
Well, Molly, what's on your mind?
Well, can't you see? Julie, I want you to meet... my friend. Mac, this is Julie. It's a nice kid.
Yeah. So I see. How are you, baby?
How do you do, Mr. Weber?
Weber? So you two know each other?
Never saw her before in my life. Listen, baby. How did you know my last name?
Why? I knew it because I heard about you. A long time ago.
Yeah?
You were important here. I saw your picture in the papers. You are Mac Weber, aren't you?
You hear that, Molly? Don't forget me easy around here, do they? That's okay.
Drinks, Molly.
Okay. Well, put them down, put them down.
Hey, I think I'll join you, ladies. Hey,
bring me the bottle, Sam.
Okay, Mac.
You two been kidding me.
What are you talking about?
I think you've been around together. The look she gives you.
Can you blame her? Say, what's your name, baby?
Julie.
Yeah, Julie. Now, Julie and me, we don't know each other. Do we, Julie?
I never met you before.
But that ain't saying we don't know each other from now on. Does it, baby?
Don't listen to him. That's an old line. He hangs it up every time he's in reach and distance of anything under 50.
Why don't you take care of the customers, Molly?
Why, I ought to bust this glass in half and take care of you.
I said take care of the customers, Molly.
Okay, big shot. See you later.
Funny dame, that, Molly. 5 years. She still thinks she's queen of the hen house. But a fella's mind can change. Yeah. It's a free country. Why not?
Mac Weber.
Oh, you seem to like the name. Well, you're going to get a chance to like the guy that's tied up to the handle. You're going to get a lot of chances, baby. A lot of chances.
So we met at last, Mac Weber, and you couldn't understand why I didn't say much. How could I? You opposite me. I'd waited so long. What was there to say? Over and over, you kept asking me, what do you know, baby? What do you know? And what I did know, I couldn't tell you. All the time, I was thinking, the cliff. The cliff. Then you wanted me to go with you. And I went with you.
Hey, slow up, baby. Take it easy. What are you trying to do, commit suicide? That's better. I gotta admit, you can drive, babe. But after all, this ain't exactly a racetrack climbing up here. Hey, tell me, what do you think of my car, huh?
It's a fine car.
You're telling me? You got any idea what this boat cost me?
No.
$15,000. Cash on the line. But that's how I am. The best of everything. And that's why I go for you, babe.
Do you? Really?
Sure. The minute I laid eyes on you, I says to myself, Mac, I says, there she is.
It's getting very dark.
Here, I says to myself, Mac, there's the kind of baby you could do things for. The kind will really appreciate the dough you spend. Say, you listening to me?
Yes. Yes, I'm listening.
Well, you wasn't looking at me.
I can't. The winding road.
You know, I can't figure you dames out at all. Here I got a swell place to go to. $40,000 it cost me to fix it up 5 years ago, not counting the furniture. But no, it ain't what you want. You gotta go driving up to the cliff.
The cliff?
Hey, what's the matter? Who do you say the cliff like that?
I only mean that, well, up there we'll be all alone, won't we?
Now you're talking. Baby, you sure got me nuts about you.
Have I? Really?
Yeah. Like I was saying, the minute I laid eyes on you at Molly's, I said to myself, Mac Weber, here's a new number's okay. And when I saw you giving me the eye, say
No, be careful.
Careful? With a swell bundle like you?
But the road, I can't drive.
Okay.
But step on it, will you? If you gotta go to the top of the mountain to be nice, let's get there. Yeah, let's get there.
Now you're here, Mac Webber, and you're going to die. No, I've talked enough. No, I tell you, I can't hear you. All I can hear in my head is this. Step back, Mac Webber. I'll give you 3 seconds to... No. No. Stand where you are. Don't come closer. I'll shoot you. I swear I will. I'll shoot you. Ah! You've got the gun. Shoot me and I'll thank you for it. All I've lived for these 5 years was to find you. And then tonight, my flesh crawled every time I looked at you. Yes, yes, that's what I said, my flesh. It crawled and it squirmed when you touched me. But I let you because I'd do anything to get you up here on the cliff. But now, I've failed. So I'll bless the bullet you send in me. No. No. Stay away from me. Stay away from me. Don't touch me. Joe! Joe! Oh, don't listen to him. He says you're dead and you can't help me.
You have just listened to The Cliff, written especially for radio by Arch Obler and featuring Miss Betty Winkler, with Frank Lovejoy, Milton C. Herman, Betty Kane, and Kurt Conway. Arch Obler's Plays. On the winds of the night, we bring you a story whispered in the night. National Broadcasting Company, RCA Building, Radio City, New York.